though, is that it's adaptability for a lot of LEC teams in the draft phase as well. And we saw this game, it was more about SKT finding that sort of pizzazz, you know, last minute switching the Tristana into the mid lane, Faker showing so much dominance on that pick that he has been practicing in solo queue, but you would have expected that to be in Teddy's hands because he's just not a awesome dude player like we thought in the LCK.
I would title the first game of Worlds this year, God is Back. Faker absolutely destroyed this game on that Tristana.
That three-man buster shot, so good.
Separating everyone away from their big tank in Reckless. Just really beautiful team fights from SKT. And that's what we want to see. If you're an SKT fan, if you want to see them pick up the trophy for a fourth time, they're going to need to get behind that man in the mid lane. Because as far as talismans are concerned, I don't think there's any better one than Faker.
Yep.
Just ridiculous stuff. But we do have a replay, guys.
It ends now.
Shit on Faker. Let's fucking go. That's big. Thank God. Fucking soul kill Faker. We're chilling. We're good. We're good.
Mid lane. Star button. Yes, we found Effort taking a lot of damage. He's got the aftershock. That's going to wear off. He's just dead. And Teddy didn't want to use his ult on him as Khan dives on forward. We still have the Divine Judgment, but it looks like they don't even use it. Finally, it comes down. And that's two kills for SKT. The jump forward, the resets from Faker has now cleared. Has found Nemesis, the 1v1. It's a dangerous one for the Lee Sin, but he still wants it. Oh! Outplays him. Faker trying to chase, but he's not even going to get there. Distracted by a red.
So this guy on Twitter, he sent me a at real quick. He said, at Lil Tyler 1 is a fucking idiot for not understanding what the Phoenix music video fully entails. Yeah, you may be adept at computer knowledge, but you lack zero musical understanding here. I fully understand the song after listening only twice. I guess you'll never conquer your demons. So I thought, well, Alex, that was a pretty fucking alpha message. I wonder what demons you've conquered. I clicked his profile. Let's just say, yeah. Hey, yeah. Alex, bud, yeah. Hey, you're a goddamn loser.
And just resource allocation and accumulating a lead without necessarily fighting. Whereas I think Hong Kong or HKA are a team that is much more willing to like fight you for gold, for you know a lead through that way, but they don't necessarily choose the right fights. It's not
tries to EQ away, he'll escape, but look at the base. HKA are still pressing in. The Nexus Tower's first to target. Instruments maybe have made a huge mistake. The Cannon Rush tries to clear out the wave. Unified flashes forward, misses the event horizon, but now the Nexus target is the tie, and Bugax is down, and HKA on the second time of asking are making their way to Worlds Group.
What a decision. They go for the base race. They just say, you know what, we don't want either of the neutrals. And they're able to push in as three. It looked like an overreach from Crash. However, he's...
Aaron, as they try and run up the river, the turn here is where you start to get a little bit antsy if you're SK Telecom. That probably projectile landing on Khan creates a distance, and they almost take down Teddy and try and turn towards Khan, but Faker is able to make it around the extra turn there at the top of the river. And you keep mentioning Frost. That Infinity Edge now going to be done for Faker.
He is massive.
He is so big. That's three items now done. Also has the extra shielding from the lifeline.
Oh my God, run, Karma, run. Run, Karma, run. Run, Karma. You know what? I have the perfect sound effect for what is about to happen. I know it. Ooh, sorry, wrong one. We'll be right back.
to see the recalls. SKT, if they had more poke, they'd actually be able to stop Mord from going back. That's the inhib, and he's out of there.
Another
Wait, no,
TP is
going for
in.
More.
Oh, they're all going!
It's a triple teleport up into the top side for SKT.
They want to win!
Uzi's going legendary. He's able to find the kill onto the Gragas. SKT are now on the Nexus turret.
Will they get close?
SKT,
Blitz.
They play the map right, and they find the Nexus.
The split.
For a player that has 200 games, 67% win rate, and 75% win rate with Yasuo on 102 games. Like, who do you trust more with Yasuo here? Who am I laning against? I'm guessing it's Tristana. That's my guess. Yo, Sykes, thank you for 11 months. Dude, I have that guy added. He's probably better than you. Probably not. Probably not. I wouldn't say he's better than me, but we'll see. I'm sure he'll do fine. He has a really good matchup bot lane, I think. Wait, is he against Trist or Caitlyn? If it's Caitlyn, it's not as good. It's Caitlyn, Nautilus. I think that's pretty shit for them, actually. All right, wait, YO! I'm against Faker! And he took my ass! Whoa! Ah!
Dump. I know that one, Jet. I know that one. As Weaver's Wall is going to come in, so Canyon looking for more Supreme Display of Talent. It's going so far around these walls, but unfortunately, the Weaver's Wall saves them from the damage. Massive Pulverize in the backline shows us that it just doesn't.
Finals right out of the gate, and now, many years later, here he is. FPX stand in front, hoist it with pride. Our first team going to Worlds, our summer 2019 LPL champion.
Congratulations to FPX for securing the first seed representative going on to Worlds. They don't have to face SKT, and this feels so well deserved. They were the first place team in regular split both seasons.
I
want
to hear an interview, honestly. I just want to hear Doombi talk about it, because we talked about how long of a road Doombi has had. 2015 summer split. Came into the LPL with Chagu Reapers, came into a finals, and ever since, there's just been so much doubt. But let's hear from him.
This has been a very difficult travel. When you've made it to the finals, across you was the old veterans, the old organization of RNG, and everything seemed...
I actually really liked seeing TL win there. And honest, I don't know what kind of like mental gymnastics people are gonna try to do to gauge my reactions relative to what's happening in the game and say otherwise. That was honestly really nice.
He's so good.
So after losing to G2, we actually tried a lot of different strategies and learned from their style, so we were able to...
Hey, producers, it's Trevor One.
Oh, looking for...
Die! Gets another knockup! Finally, one kill picked up. TB's now coming in as well. Barely alive and walking away as Barrel. The jump in! Can't find it!
He goes down the lift!
There's one kill! There's two! Look at the team fight victory! Team Liquid immediately grab four!
They're gonna look to end the game, perhaps. Here they have a mini wave. They want to finish him!
I've seen double of fight mages in mid before. This time, he pulls it off! With the quadra kill, and down mid lane they will go!
I think they've done it, look at...
Having those different options definitely paid off well for them. It's HKA going through to the group stage now as the number one seed.